Oh. Seriously? I don't understand why people don't like Amaro. Hello friends! It's Sunday, it's another cocktail book day. Yes, I skipped last Sunday. I need a little break, but today I'm back and I want to present for you a book which I think all of you who's been asking me about Amaro, and if you think it's your blind spot, but you kind of want to explore it, you should get this book. There you go. This is the wonderful book Amaro by Brad Thomas Parson. It's a very good start with the Amaro family. If you want to explore a little bit more about the Amaros, about the history, about essential cocktails, about modern Amaro cocktails, and also if you want to make your own Amaro, there is a few suggestions here. Not only that, but the actual book have the bittersweet kitchen as well. So if you like cooking and you like cocktails, everything is inside. It's a wonderful read, not very heavy, not a big book, but a very good present. Pretty much every cocktail coming with a story of the cocktail, how it's created, where it's coming from, and especially the modern one, they have quite interesting stories how they are created. So if you are really liking to explore the Amaro world, I think that book is just absolutely perfect for you. And today I'm gonna do a cocktail, of course, but just one, not two, just one, and I'm gonna keep it short. And I have a fly in the house. Yeah, get out. Yeah, the weather is warming up and we start getting them annoying flies all around. Anyway, let's don't go too much aside of the theme. So I decided to keep this a little bit shorter as a format because I'll explain to you why. But when I'm explaining, let's start making these things. So I'm gonna prepare one cocktail, which is quite nice, and I think it's very good fit for the weather at the moment because it's spring coming to summer, nice and warm. I'm hoping it's nice and warm where you are. But no matter what, the cocktail is fantastic. It's a wonderful way for you to start exploring the Amaro. If it's one of those flavors which you kind of not just yet get used to it, or it's new for you and you think I'm not sure, do I like it, do I not? Well, this cocktail I think is gonna kind of help you because obviously it's using Amaro and we're gonna use Amaro Montenegro today. But as you can see, I'm cutting some strawberries. We have fresh strawberry inside, and of course we're gonna introduce a little bit of tequila as well. So it's not gonna be kind of 100% Amaro cocktail, which you may be expecting from me to do it today. The reason why I'm not gonna do that, because if you want to explore the Amaro, if you want to learn more, if you want to understand more about the beauty of this spirit and about the history, which is kind of huge, it's amazing, I suggest going buy the book and start experimenting. You can start with one Amaro, you don't need to buy many. And there's a very good selection here in Amaros. There's a section which is gonna run through the probably most popular Amaros, so you can decide from a flavor perspective and a nose and a palate and everything, which one you wanna start with. Do you wanna start with a very bitter one, or you wanna start with probably some more mild? Because for example, if you start, let's put it this way, if you decide to start with Fernet Branca, I don't think it's gonna be a good choice, okay? The reason why is because it's a very bitter Amaro. But then you may decide to start with Amaro Montenegro, which is very nice and balanced, so you will enjoy it. You know what I mean? There's a lot of things in the book going on. And the cocktail which I'm doing today, it's one of those called Gato Amargo. Now, I'm not sure if I pronounce this the proper way, but Gato Amargo in Spanish apparently means, it's mean a bitter cat. Kind of a good name for what we have in here. Anyway, I'm chatting too much and I should have muddled the strawberry in advance, but whatever. Now, Recipe is not coming, as usual. You will get the recipe down in the description. The cocktail is very nice, refreshing, kind of a mild with a little bit of kick from the tequila, because obviously if it's just Amaro, it will be low ABV, but if you try this cocktail and you may think, oh, I want something kind of a little bit more mild to don't have this kick of the ABV, I'll just suggest don't put the tequila. Simple as that. Keep all of the rest of the ingredients, of course, but don't use the tequila. Anyway, so let's put some lime juice here. Yeah. So regarding the book, I've been reading it and some of the recipes inside is just extremely tasty. The good things with the book is that, let me just show you before I start shaking. You see, most of the recipes will come with some kind of a picture of the cocktail, or maybe picture of the place where it's created, but most of them coming with a picture of the cocktail. And it's a good kind of a selection of the cocktail and the good way of presentation, because you have the picture, you have the story, the recipe and the method how to make it, which is quite good. You see, sometimes you can have two cocktails on a page, but it's a wonderful way how it's presented. So we have here in the shaker 1 ounce 30 ml of Amaro Montenegro, 1 ounce 30 ml of Tequila Blanco, 1/2 ounce or 15 ml of fresh lime juice. The recipe saying 1 strawberry, but I decide to use 2. I don't know, I kind of like a little bit of strawberry touch. So you muddle the strawberries, you put the rest of the ingredients, and you're gonna give it a good shake with ice, of course, before you finalize with your final ingredient, which in this case, it's Fanta. Yeah, you didn't expect that. Well, let me tell you, in Spain, Fanta, it's a big thing. So I'm not surprised it find a place in this cocktail. Wonderful. Shake, very good, because you want to break this strawberry even more. Doesn't matter you muddle it, you want to break it even more. You're gonna need to double strain this cocktail, of course, because you don't want any of the strawberry going inside in your glass. And grab a big glass like that, or you can get maybe, you know, this the Spanish gin they like to serve. That's where it came all the fashion, like the big balloon glass, if you want. So I will serve in this one, because I think it looks better in this one. Fill it up with ice, double strain this wonderful red color you're gonna get, because first of all, the Amaro, the Montenegro is dark, kind of a mild dark color, brownie, but the strawberry is gonna release this lovely red color. So make sure you don't leave any of the good liquid inside, because it's obviously muddled strawberry. Your fine sieve may need a little help like this, just to give it a little knock, and that's it. Okay, wonderful. And that's your cocktail so far. Final touch is to top up with the Fanta Orange. Now for my friends overseas, US, Canada, make sure you get a Mexican Fanta, okay? That's what it says in the book, and I understand why. The reason why, for everybody else who wondering why Mexican, because as far I know, the US and Canada, I think most of the Fanta is made with the corn syrup, and the Mexican is made with a sugar cane, yeah? So, big difference in taste, definitely. Finally, garnish. Because it's Fanta Orange, you may say, oh, I don't garnish with the strawberry. I don't know, I'm just following the book like with every other book review which I do, because that's what we want. Whatever it's written, that's what we serve. And just pop one orange wheel. And of course, we're gonna need a straw. So for this one, I don't know, should I use the method? No. I think I'll go with a lovely glass straw. I have an orange glass straw, perfect. And this is, guys, how you make the Gato Amargo, bitter cat, coming from Spanish. That's the translation, that's what says in the book. Don't take it from me, take it from the book. Anyway, let's give it a quick sip. Oh, seriously? I don't understand why people don't like Amaro. You should try this. Oh my. I don't drink Fanta usually, but oh. Anyway, this is it from me. This is it from the Amaro. Brad Thomas Parsons. Never remembered author names, but I remember the book. Anyway, if you're really interested about Amaro, start with this. There's another book coming end of September. It's already been released over a year ago, but just in Italian because it's from the Italian bartender, maestro and explorer in the Amaros, and the book is absolutely phenomenal. I've already pre-ordered it, so I can't wait, but it's coming end of September, so until then I can't tell you much about it. When it's come here to my bar, I will make a episode on this book, definitely. Now, once again, if you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe, make sure you comment, share, like, all this kind of stuff which helping the channel grow. If you're one of my subscribers, thank you very much for watching, and thank you very much for sticking around. It's absolutely a pleasure to have you here. Another news, I've just released my new class for cocktail and drinks photography in a home studio without expensive lights and setup on Skillshare. So that's not a sponsored message by Skillshare, I'm just promoting my class. Okay, so if you wanna kind of explore you, or you've been thinking of doing cocktail photography, I'll have many classes coming. That's the first one, so make sure you check the link in the description. You can get 14 days Skillshare premium for free. Watch the class. If you like it, stick around Skillshare, because there's many other things you can learn in the comfort of your home, and it's a fantastic teachers there. Also, the link to the book is going to be in the description. And as always, I'll see you in another video on Thursday. Until then, go get some Amaro, get the book, and start mixing these refreshing drinks, because it's the season, guys. So now's the time to explore this wonderful liquid. And the last thing before I go, make sure you tune in on Tuesday, because I'm having an extra video on Tuesday. You'll find out why, okay? But I'll see you next time. Until then, as always, I love you. And I leave you. Bye-bye.